हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू डी एडमी। होप आप सभी का प्रिपरेशन बहुत अच्छे से चल रहे हैं और हम कंटिन्यू कर रहे हैं हमारे फिल्म्स के रिवीजन सीरीज़ के साथ फ्रॉम साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, वेयर वी आर कवरिंग द लास्ट वन एंड हाफ ईयर करंट अफेयर्स, वन एंड हाफ ईयर का करंट अफेयर्स। तो दिस इज पार्ट 23 ऑफ द लेक्चर, दिस इज पार्ट 23 ऑफ द लेक्चर। होप यू हैव सीन द अदर 22 पार्ट्स एंड होप दिस एवरीथिंग द एफर्ट विच वी आर पुटिंग इज वेरी यूजफुल फॉर यू। इफ यू वॉन्ट एनी मोर कोर्सेज ऑफ इफ यू वॉन्ट एनी मोर लेक्चर्स इन एनी थिंग फ्रॉम साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, डू लेट अस नो इन द कमेंट सेक्शन सो दैट वी विल कम अप विथ मोर सच लेक्चर्स। ओके, सो इस लेक्चर में हम कवर करते हैं डिसीज हेल्थ एंड मेडिसिन से। तो यहाँ पर हम देखते हैं पहले ट्रांसफैट्स के बारे में, आफ्टर दैट वी विल टॉक अबाउट फैजोलिसिन, वॉट इज फैजोलिसिन हम देखते हैं, उसके बाद वी विल टॉक अबाउट द पेनिसिलिन, वाई दिस वॉज इन न्यूज अगेन, आफ्टर दैट वी विल टॉक अबाउट एलिफेंट एंडोथीरोटिक हर्पस वायरस, दिस वॉज इन न्यूज रिसेंटली, वॉट इज दिस हम देखते हैं, आफ्टर दैट वी विल टॉक अबाउट लिम्फैटिक फिलेरसिस, आफ्टर दैट हम देखते हैं ऑर्गेनॉइड्स के बारे में, आफ्टर दैट वी विल टॉक अबाउट द बैक्टीरियोफेजेस, आफ्टर दैट हम देखते हैं टाइफॉइड कॉन्जुगेट वैक्सीन्स, एंटीमाइक्रोबियल रेजिस्टेंस के बारे में, मेंटल डिसऑर्डर्स के बारे में बात करते हैं, आफ्टर दैट वी विल टॉक अबाउट द अफ्रीकन स्वाइन फ्लू। तो वी विल कवर ऑल ऑफ दिस थिंग्स इन दिस लेक्चर। तो चलिए शुरू करते हैं। फर्स्ट फैजोलिसिन। सो फैजोलिसिन इज अ न्यू एंटीबायोटिक डिस्कवर्ड इन द सॉइल्स ऑफ ट्रॉपिकल रेन फॉरेस्ट। इट्स अ न्यू एंटीबायोटिक, फैजोलिसिन इज अ न्यू एंटीबायोटिक। ओके, इट वॉज रिसेंटली आइसोलेटेड डीप इन द ट्रॉपिकल फॉरेस्ट ऑफ लॉस टक्सलासोस इन मेक्सिको। So it was recently isolated in the tropical forest. It's an antibiotic found in the discovered in the soil of tropical rainforest. Okay, it was found in the root nodules of wild beans. Root nodules of the wild beans, which is also called Phaseolus vulgaris. Phaseolus vulgaris. So this unusual antibiotic is produced by a symbiotic soil bacterium that fixes the nitrogen for the plants and keeps harmful microbes away. So as you know, symbiotic. Symbiotic means the more complementary in nature. So there are bacterium which fixes nitrogen. There are bacterium in the soil which fixes nitrogen for the plants. Okay, it was found in there. It's a new antibiotic. Phazolin is a new antibiotic which is found in the soils of tropical rainforest. Next one, penicillin to fight rheumatic fever. This was recently in news. Why? Because the government is planning on the revival of penicillin in a bid to fight against the drug resistance and to tackle rheumatic heart disease. Rheumatic is a heart disease. This fever is caused because of the problem in the heart. Okay, so for this it was found that penicillin is going to be effective because these days we are witnessing the multi-drug resistance. That means a virus or bacteria, it becomes resistant to the all the available treatments. So for that, what we are doing, what we have to do is we have to bring in either new medicines or an old medicine to which this bacterium or virus is still, it is not resistant. Okay, so they are planning to bring in this penicillin. It is one of the oldest antibiotics known to man and is still effective in many cases, as not many organisms have developed resistance to this penicillin. Okay, next, elephant endotheliotropic herpes virus, EEHV. This was in news recently. So this is a rare disease that has killed 5 elephants in Odisha. It spreads from elephant to elephant only. This EEHV is a type of herpes virus that can cause a highly fatal hemorrhagic disease in the young Asian elephants between 1 and 12. So EEHV is a disease that spreads from elephant to elephant, and recently it has killed 5 elephants in Odisha. Okay, that's why this was in news. So remember, it's a disease that infects the elephants between the age of 1 to 12. And recently 5 elephants have died in Odisha. Okay, next one, lymphatic filariasis. Recently, the Union Minister for Health and Family Welfare of India has inaugurated a national symposium on the theme United to Eliminate Lymphatic Filariasis and signed the call to action to eliminate lymphatic filariasis by 2021. This lymphatic filariasis is also known as elephantiasis. So elephantiasis means you might have seen where the legs are bulged. So if this is the normal size of a leg, the people who are suffering from elephantiasis will have legs of this size. So their legs width would have been doubled. Okay, so this lymphatic filariasis is the elephantiasis, and recently a national level symposium on the theme United to Eliminate Lymphatic Filariasis has been यू नो इनॉग्रेटेड, हैज बीन इनॉग्रेटेड. ओके, इट्स कॉल दिस लिम्फेटिक फिलेरियासिस इज कॉज्ड बाय एन इन्फेक्शन विद पैरासाइटिक वॉर्म्स लिविंग इन द लिम्फेटिक सिस्टम. नेक्स्ट वन, ऑर्गेनॉइड्स. सो व्हाट आर ऑर्गेनॉइड्स? ऑर्गेनॉइड्स आर ए ग्रुप ऑफ सेल विच आर ग्रोन इन लैबोरेटरीज इन थ्री डायमेंशनल मिनिएचर स्ट्रक्चर्स दैट मिमिक द सेल अरेंजमेंट ऑफ ए फुल्ली ग्रोन ऑर्गन. सो इट मिमिक्स द सेल अरेंजमेंट ऑफ ए फुल्ली ग्रोन ऑर्गन. ओके, सो दीज आर द टाइनी ऑर्गन लाइक स्ट्रक्चर्स दैट डू नॉट अचीव ऑल द फंक्शनैलिटी ऑफ ए मेच्योर ह्यूमन ऑर्गन. इवन दो इट्स ए थ्री डायमेंशनल स्ट्रक्चर, लाइक यू कैन सी लाइक दिस, इवन दो इट्स ए थ्री डायमेंशनल स्ट्रक्चर, इट कैनॉट फुल्ली मिमिक एन एंटायर ह्यूमन ऑर्गन बिकॉज इट्स स्टिल द अर्ली एज ऑफ डेवलपमेंट ऑफ ए टिश्यू. बिकॉज वॉट वी हैव डन इज वी हैव मेड इट इन टू थ्री डायमेंशनल स्ट्रक्चर बट इट शुड बी गिवन मोर लाइफ ओनली देन इट इज पॉसिबल. सो मोस्ट ऑफ द ऑर्गनॉइड्स कंटेन ओनली अ सबसेट ऑफ द सेल सीन इन द रियल ऑर्गन्स बट एज आई टोल्ड यू दे लैक द रियल ब्लड वेसल्स टू मेक दम फुल्ली फंक्शनल. सो एज द रिसर्च इज गोइंग ऑन इन फ्यूचर वील बी एबल टू अचीव दिस ऑल्सो आर्टिफिशियल ऑर्गन्स विच आर बींग प्रिपेयर्ड बाई यस एंड दे विल बी इम्प्लांटेड इन टू द ह्यूमन बींग्स. ओके, नेक्स्ट वन, बैक्टीरियोफेजेस. So bacteriophages, what are bacteriophages? These are the viruses that kill the bacteria. These are viruses that kill the bacteria. These are composed of the protein capsule around the RNA or DNA genome. Protein capsule around the RNA or DNA genome. Okay. These are seen as a possible therapy against the multi-drug resistant strains of many bacteria. So recently, as we know, many bacteria are developing this resistance to the multi-drugs. So this will become very useful. Next is the typhoid conjugate vaccine. So Pakistan recently has become the first country in the world to introduce the World Health Organization recommended typhoid conjugate vaccine, TCV. So Pakistan is the first country, to adopt this World Health Organization recommended typhoid conjugate vaccine. This typhoid conjugate vaccine, it's still in developmental stage, so stage 3 trials are still going on, but Pakistan has adopted this. It's become the first country. So this is to prevent the typhoid fever. Next one, antibiotic resistance. So what is the antibiotic resistance means? It means that the microorganism, that is the bacteria or virus which is living in the human beings, it has become resistant to certain kind of drugs. That means if you take any drug also, this will not affect, this will not kill that microorganism, either bacteria or virus. Okay. So as I told you, this is the ability of an organism like bacteria or virus and some of the parasites to stop an antimicrobial from working against it. As a result, standard treatments become ineffective and we have to search for new methods of treatment. Next one, mental disorders high in South India. So recently a study titled Burden of Mental Disorders Across the States in India, Global Burden of Disease Study 1990-2017 conducted by the Indian Council of Medical Research and Public Health Foundation of India, ICMR ने ये study को publish किया. तो what are the key findings? इस study का key findings क्या है? It has found out that people in South India especially, they have various kinds of mental disorders. Mental disorders are more in South India. Okay, back in 2017, there were 19.73 crore people with mental disorders, which comprise of 14.3% of total population of the country. Okay, so this is about the study, which is released by Indian Council of Medical Research and Public Health Foundation of India. Next one, African swine flu fever. So this ASF, African swine flu fever, has been sweeping through the populations in China. It is leading to massive mass cullings of subsequent increase in the price of country's favorite proteins. So recently this was found in China. As you know, a lot of diseases originate in China because of the wet markets of China. The wet markets of China where animals are being killed and sold. Those markets are the markets where the selling of the animals, the meat takes place. Okay, these are very unhygienic, so that those becomes one of the hotspot for various diseases. So recently this African swine flu fever, this was started there. So this ASF is highly contagious and fatal animal disease that infects domestic and wild pigs, typically resulting in an acute form of hemorrhage fever. So it causes fever and certain diseases in the pigs. It was first discovered in Africa in 1920, so that is why this is called the African swine flu fever. So now let's revise what we have studied so far. So trans fats. So as we have seen, the trans fats The FSSAI, Food Safety Standard Authority of India, it has launched a trans fat free logo. Okay, so permissible limit of trans fat by WHO is less than 1% of the total energy intake. So the trans fats are very harmful for earth, for humans. So we have to reduce the intake of the trans fats, which is found in a lot of vegetable oils and the other kind of food that we are taking in these modern days. Okay, so FSSAI, the Food Safety Standard Authority of India, has launched the trans fat free logo. Next, we have seen Fazolin. It's a new antibiotic discovered in the soil of a tropical rainforest. Okay, this was found in the root nodules of wild beans. Okay, it was found in Mexico. This is about Fazolin. Next, recently we have seen the penicillin is going to be reintroduced in order to fight the rheumatic fever. This is caused due to problems in the heart. So this is a fever caused due to problems in heart, and penicillin is going to be reintroduced so that in order to fight against this disease. Next, elephant endothelialitic herpes virus. This virus, you know, this transmits from elephant to elephant, and recently it has killed elephants in Odisha. So that's why this was in news. Next one, lymphatic filariasis. So in order to eliminate this lymphatic filariasis, recent national symposium was organized on the theme United to Eliminating Lymphatic Filariasis. Next, we have seen organoids. Organoids are a group of cells that are grown in laboratories into three-dimensional miniature structures, but those are not live, or you can say those are not, they cannot live. They still have a lot of things, they still have a lot of what you call them. A lot of things that have to be done in order to make them live and functional. So these are simply the structures that are created in laboratory, three-dimensional structures. Next, we have seen about bacteriophages. These are the viruses that can kill the bacteria. Okay, these are the protein capsule around RNA or DNA genome. They are seen as a possible therapy against the multi-drug resistance of many bacteria. So a virus killing a bacteria is nothing but bacteriophages. Next one, we have seen the typhoid conjugate vaccine. Pakistan has become the first country in the world to introduce this typhoid conjugate vaccine. This has fully not yet developed. So this is to fight against the typhoid fever. Next, we have seen the antibiotic resistance, AMR. So this antibiotic resistance means the resistance is, you know, the bacteria or the virus that is infecting a person has gained the resistance against the available drugs, and the available drugs are the available treatment for that disease is no more efficient, it is no more working against that. So that is the antibiotic resistance, AMR. Next one, mental disorders high in South India. Recently, a study titled Burden of Mental Disorders Across the States of India, Global Burden of Diseases Study 1990-2007 has been published by Indian Council for Medical Research and Public Health Foundation of India. So what they have to, what this, you know, this has just a minute, what this study has, you know, showcased is the people in South India have more mental disorders. Okay, next, African swine flu fever. The African swine flu fever outbreak has been in China recently. It was seen in China. It was first discovered in 1920s in Africa, and it transmits among the animals like pigs, wild pigs especially. Okay, this is about the African swine flu fever. Okay, next, that's it, friends. We have seen this lecture. I'll see you again in the next lecture. Till then, keep studying and stay tuned. Jai Hind.